Thank you. Thank you, Jeff English and the Unity Band. You sound fantastic, as always. Welcome to Unity Spiritual Center of Lansing, live streaming to you from 2395 Washington Road. I'm Greg Denning, and I'm filling in while Reverend Sharon is healing from a minor surgery. So, we encourage each of you to take whatever COVID precautions make you the most comfortable. Masks and hand sanitizer are available to everyone. And if you're with us for the first time, a special welcome. If you did not receive our welcome gift on the way in, just raise your hand and an usher will bring it to you. Okay, and during service and afterward, the coffee bar is open for self-service. If you have a prayer need, our prayer team is ready to pray with you. Just place your prayer request in the prayer box behind the yellow sofa. Call the church office or place your prayer request online through our website. You can keep updated on Unity events through social media, our website, or you can call the church office. And if you are new to Unity, you can use one of the connection cards on the table that can help us connect with you. And anyone can use the connection cards to share ideas or recommendations with the minister and the Board of Trustees. If you are joining us online, send an email to Reverend Sharon to say hello. Now let's begin our work by affirming our health and wholeness together. Here I am, spirit, celebrating life. The individual cells of my body are free to unite together to support me in health and wholeness. Ownership of dis-ease is a defamation of our character. I release any thoughts of dis-ease, and I affirm my strength and resiliency. Stronger together, every organ of my body strives to work in harmony as one living system, reverberating and regenerating as part of the universal life force. Wholeness and vitality are made manifest within me, through me, and as me. And so it is. Amen. Here at Unity, our mission is to spiritually awaken to our oneness with God, with each other, and with all creation. Our mission comes out of our vision, which is a world powerfully transformed through the growing movement of a shared spiritual awakening. And because we honor all paths, let us begin with this ecumenical prayer. The enlightenment of the Buddha shines within us. The compassion of the Christ moves through us. The power of Jehovah strengthens and guards us. The presence of Allah surrounds and guides us. Wherever we are, the Tao is, and all is God. And to get ourselves in harmonious synchronization with consciousness, I invite you to sing with me Our Thoughts, Our Prayers.
Our thoughts are prayers, and we are always praying. Our thoughts are prayers, take charge of what you're saying. Seek a higher consciousness, a state of peacefulness. And know that God is always there. And every thought becomes a prayer.
Now let's continue in prayer, where we bless our neighbors. And our neighbors are everyone around us, everyone across the world, anyone living. So let's join together. In this moment, we lift our gaze to discover our shared humanity. We affirm freedom for people around the world, freedom from fear, pain, and suffering. God is with them and within them in this very moment, comforting and guiding them to a life of grace and harmony. We celebrate with others for the joys of life. We see each individual free to discover the truth that will bring them hope for their future. Heart to heart, we dwell in a oneness moving toward peace for all humanity. And so it is. Allah, Shalom, Amen, Namaste. And we keep our own cups full so we can continue to support others as we pray for Unity Spiritual Center, which is you and me. With a heart full of gratitude for the many blessings which continue to pour down upon us, Unity Spiritual Center responds to the loving urges of spirit in our thoughts, words, and actions. We are enlivened to be of service. We are engaged with what really matters. We are teachable and growable as we thrive in fulfilling our sacred calling. Reaching in, we reach out to truly be a force for good in our world. And so it is. Allah, Shalom, Amen, Namaste. And we've come to our discussion question for the morning. So among you at your tables, please think about an answer. Would you rather be happy or right? And we'll join back together in a few minutes for our opening song. Now we're going to join together in our opening song, My Soul is Welcome Here.
I'm in the right place at the right time. I am just where I'm supposed to be. I'm in the right place at the right time. I am just where I'm supposed to be. I'm in the right place at the right time. I am just where I'm supposed to be. I'm in the right place at the right time. I am just where I'm supposed to be. Oh, my soul is welcome here. Oh, my soul is welcome here. I am getting the message loud and clear. My soul is welcome here. I'm in the right place at the right time. I am just what I'm supposed to be. I'm in the right place at the right time. I am just what I'm supposed to be. I'm in the right place at the right time. I am just what I'm supposed to be. I'm in the right place at the right time. I am just what I'm supposed to be. Oh, my soul is welcome here. Oh, my soul is welcome here. I am getting the message loud and clear. My soul is welcome here. 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 Oh, my soul is welcome here. My soul is welcome here. You get it? My soul is welcome here. Two more times. My soul is welcome here. Oh, my soul is welcome here. I am getting the message loud and clear. My soul is welcome here.
Good morning, I'm Maggie Bishop, and I'm your platform assistant for today. Our daily word is let go, let God. Inspired by the Gospel of John, do not let your hearts be troubled. Believe in God, believe also in me. If we find ourselves ruminating over a concern or a weighty decision, we release its grip on our attention by letting go and letting God. When we let go, we are placing our trust in divine mind, the source of infinite potential. We believe there are solutions and remedies of which our limited human mind can simply not conceive. When we let go, we are trusting the grace of God will bless our lives in the most wondrous and even surprising ways. Letting go and letting God is how we live our faith. We surrender to a spiritual truth, the presence and power of God, and believe the best outcome is to be much better than anything we can imagine. We affirm that we let go and let God and relax into knowing we are deeply loved and abundantly blessed. Let's affirm together. I bless myself when I let go and let God. This month's focus is on our core value of freedom. We have each been gifted with the freedom to be, to explore, and to express beyond any misperceived personal limitations. We believe life is a matrix of oneness, so our own freedom is mutually dependent on the freedom of others to explore and to live free and unlimited. Freedom is a powerful force. It breathes in us as a right to life, not only for ourselves, but for every living being. Let's be a champion of that right. Let's affirm together our core value together. We champion each individual's freedom to become a full expression of spirit. And announcements for today. This week, on the Friday, August 5th, is the Lunch Bunch, a social group that is open to everyone. This week, they're meeting at the Logan's Roadhouse on West Saginaw Highway. It's helpful to contact Nancy Cleaner or the church office so we can reserve enough seats. But if you're free at the last minute, drop-ins are welcome. Sundays at 9:30, Unity offers Sunday adult learning time, or what we call SALT. Next Sunday, Curtis Pratt is back by popular demand to bring us new insights in the ancient Greek mythology. If you haven't bought your tickets yet, we're resurrecting our summer tradition of attending a Lugnuts game together Friday, August 19th. The group rate ticket is $17, which includes a hot dog and a soft drink. Today is the last day to purchase tickets. See Lisa Heston to reserve yours now. Lisa, could you stand up so everybody knows who you are? If you're joining us virtually, contact the Unity office to make arrangements for your tickets. Ready to create some spectacular on our campus? Join Lisa Heston on Sunday, August 7th, following the service for an organizational meeting to build a labyrinth on our campus. The team will choose a design, a location, and create a work schedule to bring it to life. Sunday, August 14th, musical message service. In just 3 weeks, Armand and Angelina are coming to Lansing for a return engagement. They will provide an outstanding Sunday musical service followed by native flute workshop. Then on Monday night, they are presenting a fun and lively concert. Details on the workshop and the concert are on flyers on the table. Each table has several sheets with information about August activities. Please take one for easy reference. Additional information on our activities and teams can be found on our website and e-news and our information rack. If you have any questions or would like to sign up for the weekly e-news, please leave a message on the church office by phone or email, or use the connection cards on the table. Now it's my pleasure to welcome Elizabeth Kunc.
When people ask him how he likes on the way to where I'm going. I'm not afraid because I know this is my temporary home. Young mom on her own, she needs a little help, got nowhere to go. She's looking for a job and looking for a way out. A halfway house will never be home. At night she whispers to her baby girl, someday we'll find our place here in this world. This is our temporary home. Where we belong, windows and rooms that we're passing through. This is just a stop on the way to where we're going, and I'm not afraid because I know this is our temporary home. And he whispers, don't cry for me, I'll see you all someday. He looks up and says, I can see God's face. And this was my temporary home. It's not where I belong. Windows and rooms that we're passing through. This is just a stop on the way to where we're going. And I'm not afraid because I know this is my
Thank you. Thank you so much. And I got to apologize. We misspelled your last name on the slide. So everybody watching from home and in here ends with a C, not a Z. So anyway, I was going to fix that, but it was a little busy before service around here. So now, let's see here. Sorry. Okay, now it's my pleasure to welcome back Greg Bowens. He spoke with us maybe about a month or so ago. He's a student at Unity's Urban Ministerial School in Detroit, an author, a prayer chaplain at Renaissance Unity, as well as the Wayne County Sheriff's Department. Greg Bowens.
Thank you. It's so wonderful to be with you again. I love coming up here. I got to tell you, this morning I woke up early to catch a sunrise. I try and do that at least once during the summer because it's so beautiful, and I caught it. But the sun comes up, it said at 6:23, right? And you know, but that's when the sun is fully risen. If you want to catch the sunrise, you got to get there a little earlier in order to catch it as it starts to peek over the horizon. And I was lucky enough to be able to do that this morning. And I think that that's one of the things that is so important to me, and I like to share it with people because it allows for us to be able to really ease into the day and see the majesty of creation, as it were, and really feel our place in it. It's a beautiful thing, and I would encourage you to do it. And then after that, I had this wonderful opportunity to drive 90 minutes to get up here, over 100 miles, you know, and that's just the latest leg in the journey, because it's taken me more than 50 years to get to this point, to be able to be with you in community. And I am so happy to be able to do it. You know, what you have created here is amazing. And what Craig does with the gardening and the landscaping, along with the other crew, is just a spectacular thing to do. So everybody who may be watching at home or within the sound of my voice, if you get the opportunity to come to Unity Lansing, please take that opportunity and come. It is proof positive that we make a space holy and affirm the goodness of this world wherever we may be, wherever we may gather. And you have certainly done that here. And so I am so very, very, you know, grateful for that. And please give yourself a round of applause for what you have created. It is beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. As the pastors like to say, I won't be long today. I won't keep you long, but I will start out with a little prayer. And if we could just take a moment to kind of ease into this, and as you feel, close your eyes or leave them open, but let's take a deep breath. And let's take another deep breath. And in this moment, we let go of the cares and concerns of the world, and we center our attention in God, recognizing that there is only one power and one presence that is active in the universe and in our life, and that is God the Good. And as children of God, we have the qualities of God within us, and we express those qualities as love and peace and happiness. And we let love and peace and happiness flow from person to person throughout this room, throughout the internet, anybody that's watching. And we let love, peace, and happiness flow through our being. We give thanks for our community. We give thanks for the right and perfect healing for Reverend Sharon, and that she is on her feet, moving around, expressing love and joy, and bringing that manifestation to everyone that she meets. We see the right and perfect healing taking place for her and for everyone on our heart and mind. Thank you, thank you, thank you, God. Amen. I think that today is a beautiful day, another beautiful day, another wonderful opportunity to be with you. And I've come here spending this time, driving this way, as a person of the Christian faith who has walked with Jesus and seen him walk on water and seen the Red Sea part and seen all those lovely stories in the Bible, just so we could have this opportunity to recognize that our goal is to actually take the message of Jesus and remember our oneness with God. And so today I'm going to talk about that oneness, that love plus happiness equals you. A new math, a new way to sort of define ourselves as we move and groove in this world, understanding and always walking in that love and happiness. Because I tend to believe that happiness is a pathway to experiencing a deeper relationship with God, with the divine. And why shouldn't we be happy in that oneness, recognizing all the beauty that exists in this world, all the good that exists in this world, all the good that exists within you? We are spiritual beings having a human experience, And so I'll start off with the end of that equation and do like algebra and work backwards. You, me, we, what are we? Right? We are divine beings having a human experience, spiritual beings having a human experience, and what makes up us? Well, there are two really big components, I think, that we should be mindful of. One is our identity. How do we identify ourselves? Our identity is made up of our personality and our individuality. Our personality are those things that we take on the surface. Our ego, who am I? I'm a teacher, I'm a doctor, I'm a cop, I'm a this or that, or this or that. And we tend to identify ourselves through what it is that we do. Now, you're bigger than your job, you're bigger than your bank account, you're bigger than any kind of way that someone can be used to describe you. And we know that intuitively, but many times we default into the comfort that the ego provides on, this is what I am. I am a singer. Not really. I mean, you don't want to get me to start singing in here. But, you know, when we identify in that kind of way, then we start to act to fit that mold and conduct ourselves in life, throughout life, from that prospect. You ever meet a police officer or a lawyer who just can't turn it off? They're always a cop, or they're always a lawyer, arguing, you know, for this, that, and the other. That's the ego part, and many times the ego can lead us to a very limited perspective of ourselves, particularly as we absorb, you know, negative connotations out there about who we are and what that means. So we kind of move beyond that. But that's personality. The other part is individuality. This is our true nature, who we really are, and how we develop and grow and show our Christ consciousness. The other part of you, me, we, our identity, that's really important is the four levels of consciousness, the four parts of consciousness. And that exists in the way that one, our senses. How do we sense? How do we feel? How do we look at things? The other thing, the other way is the way that we feel. And then there's the way that we think. And then there is the way that we tune into our intuitive nature. That little voice within us that is God, Spirit, the Divine, always talking to us in our connection to divine mind. And when we are able to be awake and aware of those four different personalities or parts of consciousness, we can master them and take more control of our being so that we can express the good, the joy, the love, make God real, make love real in this world. And that's really important. So that's the you, that's the me, that's the we, that's the us, and how we look at ourselves. So how do we look at ourselves differently now? Well, I suggest a new math, a new way of looking at it. One is, if you follow me and talk to me at all, and you can follow me on Facebook, happiness, the idea of happiness. The Bible speaks about joy and happiness a lot throughout it. The joy in the Lord, the happiness of creation. And when I talk about happiness, I'm not just talking about doing cartwheels and flips and jumping up and down, which is an expression of happiness, and it's cool, because sometimes we feel like that, dancing like no one's watching, and things of that nature. But I'm talking about a deeper sort of level of joy, the kind of joy that you get from, and you might remember this, and some of you may still do it, I certainly do, laying on the grass and looking up at the sky on a perfect day, or walking on the grass and feeling the grass beneath your feet. The idea of sitting still and looking at your surroundings and finding joy and beauty in what you see, or in the person that is sitting next to you, that you share your life with, things of that nature. Happiness rooted in love, which is the second part of the equation, I think is really, really, really important. And when we think about love, what do we think about? How do we feel love? How do we open ourselves up to love? Because love is all around us. Love is within us. We describe God as love, the divine as love. And I think that we intuitively know what love is. Now, Paul, the Apostle Paul, who, you know, got his epiphany on the road and went all over the place preaching about Jesus and this guy that he never met, but now he believes before he was prosecuting him and all that stuff. In 1 Corinthians, he talks about the qualities of love. In 1 Corinthians chapter 13, verse 4 through 7, he says, love is patient, love is kind, it does not envy, it does not boast, it is not proud, it is not rude, it is not self-seeking, it is not easily angered, it keeps no record of wrong. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices in truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, always perseveres, and love never fails. He talks about this as the qualities of love so that we can recognize love when we see it, and we can recognize love when we express it in those kinds of ways. But that's like pointing to the moon and looking at your finger and saying, look at that wonderful finger, right? Because what we're really talking about is the power of love, the power that gives us the ability to not be boastful, to not be shaming people, to not do all those things, right? And so when we can sit still, when we can center ourselves, when we can focus our awareness on God and experience our oneness with God, and then we can make decisions that affirm our happiness, that point us in the direction of happiness, that point us back to God. Sometimes I feel like John the Baptist running around talking about repent, repent, right? Repent, repent. How do you do that? What is that all about? Well, that is all about turning away from the bad, turning away from what they call evil, but we know it's life spelled backwards or live spelled backwards and all those things that are opposite of being able to live. And we just say, take a shift away from those things that we see that diminish life as opposed to expand life and our place in life. It's a small shift. The last time I came up here and drove 100 miles to be with you, it was another beautiful day, but gas was over $5 a gallon. And I taught from this very podium about not worrying about the gas price, but find, you know, if you've got 25 bucks, spend that 25 bucks and it'll go as far as it'll go and things will take care of themselves. Now, a month later, the other day, I filled up before I came here, I paid $3.88 to get up here. I know, that's cheap. Cash is king, baby. But I say that to say that things can tend to ebb and flow, and all the worry that we put on our heads about how am I going to make it and what am I going to do and all this stuff, gas is so high, have shifted. But did our focus shift? Are we now worried that I got to pay $3.88 a gallon as opposed to $2.50 a gallon? Am I still worried and focused on that? No, I'm not. And neither, none of us should be. We have to shift our focus, bless what we have, stay rooted in love, and let that guide our happiness. And if we marry love, being rooted in love, with choosing to be happy, then we have a way, a new way to define ourselves. I am not just loving, I am love. I am not just happy, I am happiness. It is bringing forth the power of God, manifesting the good that exists in the universe and letting it manifest through you, through me, and everyone that we meet. And even if we're not meeting anybody at the moment, even if we're sitting alone, you ever heard the expression that you can be your own worst enemy? That's true. But why be our own worst enemy when we can be our greatest cheerleader? When we can be the one that says, I get that. That happened. And this is happening. But I declare that it has no power over me. That I am connected with the divine. I am the divine. I am love. And I never fail because I am love. And so we know the qualities of love as they are expressed by Paul. And we know the feeling of love as it exists in our lives, whether it was that holding grandma's hand when we were a little kid, or being touched by someone for the first time in a way that moved our soul, or standing in the sun and closing our eyes and feeling that energy. I'm almost out of time for being right here, but I want to leave you with this thought, that we have the opportunity to think of ourselves in a new way, as the divine beings that we were born to be, that we exist whether we want to acknowledge it or not, as the conduit of God's hands and feet in this world, and the opportunity to radiate the good that exists within us, to bring that love forward, to live in a level of happiness that sustains us. And so I thank you for being here today. I thank you for sharing love. I thank you for sharing joy. I thank you for creating this wonderful community. And I look forward to the good that you will bring forward in the days and weeks to come. Love plus happiness equals you. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Greg. We're going to move into a time of meditation.
Yes.
So if you wouldn't mind staying here for a little bit and guiding us on that. Thank you.
Pour over me, Holy Spirit, cleanse my heart and comfort me. Pour over me, Holy Spirit, help me know how to let go. Pour over me, Holy Spirit, cleanse my heart and comfort me. Pour over me, Holy Spirit, help me know how to let go.
And so everyone, let's take a deep breath. And let's take another deep breath. And in this moment, we center our attention on God, the Divine Spirit. And we just let our thoughts be there. Just focus your thoughts on God. As we focus our thoughts on God, we inhale love and we exhale peace. We inhale love and we exhale peace. Inhale love, exhale peace. As we return our awareness to this moment, to this room, we give thanks for the love and peace. We give thanks for the love and peace that exists in and through us, as us. Amen.
Power and love.
Thank you so much, Greg, for being here today. I really enjoy your talks. And I hope you're back with us again real soon. And now it's my pleasure to, hey, name spelled right this time. Welcome Elizabeth back up for some more wonderful music.
This is the time during our Sunday service when we engage in the sacred practice of generosity. Our unity community is in constant appreciation to each of you for the support coming to unity through many channels, online, mail, love offerings shared in person. Our circle of generosity includes the act of gratitude for these many gifts by sharing our gifts with others. A portion of our tithes this quarter are being sent to Carefree Medical, in support of them providing care for those who would otherwise go without. Let's take a moment to deeply immerse ourselves in gratitude by singing I Am So Blessed.
I am so blessed, I am so blessed, I am so grateful for all that I have. I am so blessed, I am so blessed, I am so grateful, I am so blessed. I am so blessed, I am so blessed, I am so grateful for all that I have. I am so blessed. I am so blessed. I am so grateful.
The circle of generosity is the sacred exchange of giving and receiving. With joy and enthusiasm, we each become a part of the sacred exchange, sharing of our blessings to complete the circle. If you are sharing in person, you can leave your love offering envelope in the glass jar on the table when you are complete with blessing it. The ushers will collect them following service. On that same glass jar, on the broadcast screen is a QR code you can use to donate through PayPal using your cell phone. Whether we are sharing online, in person, or through the mail, allow the power of generosity to flow through you as you make this sacred act of giving. Together, love through me blesses and multiplies all that I am, all that I have, all that I give, and all that I receive. I praise, give thanks, and am glad. Now let's stand together as we sing our closing song, I Choose Love.
Peace in my life is growing because I choose love. Love's always present, it's what we're made of. I choose love. We are a part of each other. We are one. One tie that binds us, that can't be undone. I choose love. Peace on the planet is growing because I choose love. Let love be present, it's what we're made of. I choose love. We are a part of each other. We are one. One tie that binds us, that can't be undone. I choose love. I choose love. We choose love.
The light of God surrounds us. The love of God enfolds us. The power of God protects us. The presence of God is within us. Wherever we are, God is, and all is well.